Initial Moms.
Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday.
Welcome to Spirit Talks
with Tao.
Thanks for being here, homies. Today, kind of want to bounce off last week's video. I was talking about everything that's happening over these past several months. Everyone's been feeling like they're going crazy. You are confronted with a lot of darkness. If you haven't checked out last week's video, you should probably go watch that. But coming into August, there's a lot of energy gateways. That's a way for this energy to come through. And since all the energy is coming in, it's causing different things to happen within us. Physically, emotionally, mentally, shit's lit energetically this month. So, how to deal with these things? I have for you six tips on how to handle these energies coming in, things that you can do to just every day make life feel better, because it can be crazy. All those new things coming in, doing stuff to your body. Sometimes you can feel really fatigued and tired. You can have migraines. Sometimes people feel nauseous for no reason, feel unbalanced, hazy, you forget a lot of things. A bunch of different symptoms. But I have six tips on how to deal with this new energico. Tip number one. Grounding. It helps you anchor these energies into the earth, and it helps you to better deal with them. The easiest way to do it, you can go outside and take off your shoes, put your feet in the dirt, put your toes in there, wiggle them around and stuff. Be quiet and get in tune with this energy. And a thing that you can do to better ground yourself is to visualize while your toes are sucked in the dirt, like roots coming out your feet, just like a tree. And they're digging into the earth and they're going all throughout your backyard or wherever you are. Visualize any negative energy that you may be feeling passing through your body into these roots that you have now grown, like as if like it's like black like smoke or black like static or something. Visualize it going into the earth and turning into white or bright lights, like little sparkles or something like that. And what you're doing with that visualization is you're actually moving the energy through your body into those roots and into the earth. And the earth's energy is like transmuting it into light. So when you visualize it going from like dark into like sparkles and happiness, it's like transmuting that energy. That's very simple. It takes a couple minutes. Oh, my beard.
You are a famous kitty.
He's not a normal cat.
Just like me.
Out of my face, bro.
Tip number dos is meditation. Every time I say that to most people that do not meditate on a regular basis, it's, I've tried, I can't get into that mindset, I keep thinking about stuff. Something happens to prevent them from actually being able to meditate. I have different options of meditation that, especially for people who don't actively meditate, it's easier to do. Something I read in a book, it's actually called The Seat of the Soul. But it was saying that when you get to a stoplight, everything else stops. The car stops, your body stops, but your mind doesn't, it keeps going. So when you're sitting at a stoplight, try to quiet your mind. Try and stop your mind like everything else. And just take a few deep breaths. In meditation, when you do take deep breaths and it's calculated and it's conscious breath, it's like your way to get to that altered state. Just let your mind sit with your body and with the car. That's a form of meditation. Sitting quietly outside with no phone, turn your phone off, have no stimulation. That's a form of meditation. And just try to be with your breath. Let your thoughts flow. It's okay to think about stuff. Everyone thinks about stuff. It's automatic, but just kind of let it flow. Group meditations and crystal ball meditations for beginner meditators are the best because you're in that energy, you're in that environment, so you'll naturally be able to get into that state a lot easier. So. Meditation is not as hard as it seems. We're off. Two. Number three.
Crystals. I love crystals. Some people call them rocks. Crystals are not just rocks. They have like really awesome little energy. That was a poor explanation of what a crystal is. You should probably Google it. I just love them. I have them. I use them all the time. I carry them with me in my pocket, in my purse, in my bra. I don't care. They come with me everywhere I go. They're good energy amplifiers. So let's say if you want to attract something in your life and you get a crystal and you hold it with you and you take it with you, it's going to already amplify the kind of energy that you have to manifest that stuff already. It'll bring that into your life a lot quicker and start to help you manifest that into your life. So they're awesome little energy buddies to carry with you. You can have crystals for protection. You can have crystals to help you with anxiety. You can have crystals to help you with nightmares and insomnia, to attract abundance into your life, to attract good luck, to attract love. They're awesome and they work. They really, really do. So when you get one of these crystals, love it. Take care of it. Put them outside. Put them under a full moon. Let them soak up all the energy juju. I highly suggest going to a crystal shop. You don't even have to look them up. The best way to pick a crystal is intuitively. Go to one of these stores, so look around, see what you got in front of you, and be like, this one's catching my attention. I'm gonna pick it up. That's most likely the one that you need to get. And your spirit is drawing you to that crystal, and it's for a reason, and it's your intuition. Google ain't got nothing on intuition. I think we're on to the next one. On to number four is asking the universe for guidance. I know I said that in the last video, but I kind of wanted to go smidgen more in depth, as that is a very important tip to utilize every single day. It can be in the form of prayer. It can be asking in your mind. You can ask ancestors, your spirit guides, angels. You can ask God, ask goddess. Angels are real, and you have spirit guides that surround you, and that is their job. Their job is to be with you and protect you, guide you and help you. But you have free will, so they can't just do it for you. You have to ask them. You have to actively ask for help. Be like, hey, dude, I need some guidance. Please give me a definitive lead. Please give me an answer. Show me a sign. Lead me to where I'm supposed to be. I ask for your help. I ask for your guidance. Saying those things, you're activating your free will, and you're using that free will to ask them for their help, and they will intervene, and they will help. They will guide you, and they will send you signs and symbols and leads and put people in your life that are exactly who you need to meet to go to the place where you need to be next. And you can do that every day. You can do it several times a day. You can ask and ask and ask for things. These beings, these higher dimensional, higher vibrational beings, most of them have lived this life before. They know how hard it is. They know what it's like. And they want to help you through it. And they're there for that. So help them do their job. Utilize the team that you are born with. Utilize the team that you have around you and that are there to support you and help you and guide you. So ask. Utilize your free will for a really good thing. And ask for help, because we all need it sometimes. This is not bound to anything religious. Religion is a very human thing. It's something that humans created. We made that little box, and then we stuffed all this stuff in it and said, this is religion. This is this. So if you're like, I don't believe in angels, or I don't believe in this because I'm not Christian or Catholic, it has nothing to do with that. Go with your heart. If that resonates with you, I highly suggest doing it. You'll be amazed, absolutely amazed of the stuff that comes into your life after you start actually working with the beings that are here with you to help you. But we're almost done. Let's get number five. Affirmations. I wish I wrote that on my palms. We're actually zooming through this. I thought this was going to take forever. Affirmations. It's basically repeating something over and over your head and affirming it to yourself. Sometimes I have really bad anxiety when I'm around a lot of people. That gives me a lot of anxiety, too much energy for me there. But I use affirmations a lot to help me with that. What you do with affirmations is you choose something to say and you repeat it over and over again in your head. And over time, especially when you do it all the time, as soon as you start saying those affirmations, it brings you peace. It brings you like a sense of being calm. Like for me, for example, I say all is well. And I repeat all is well. Everything's all right. Everything is okay. I'm protected. You know, just repeating that stuff to yourself. There are specific ones that you can say that have very specific energies to them and, you know, help to manifest certain things. But you should look them up. You can do like positive affirmations and choose one that you like. You can make them up for yourself. Those definitely help, will help you through this time of all this energy going on. And last, but not least, no, six. Visualization. It's visualization. Not so much with these eyes. This one here. Imagination. That's a very important tool. It's how you manifest everything. Some people crush that in children, and that's not okay. Foster that, because that's how you make the life of your dreams. Visualization is my last tip for this episode of Spirit Talks with Me. The reason why I'm doing it last is because all this energy that's coming in this month, it's a big, big, heavy time to really anchor what you want. What do you want in your life? What kind of life do you want? Have you thought about that lately? Well, think about it and design the life that you want. What's your sole purpose in this life? Figure that out. Design it in your mind and visualize it. And hold that image. Try to experience what emotions you would feel in this new state, in this perfect world that you want. And put yourself there and feel it. All that stuff is creative manifestation energy. And right now, it's really good for that. It's energy that's gonna help. The work that you do, it's like adding a bunch of work itself to it and kind of like helping to make it what you want it to be and anchor it into this world. Make sure it's coming from a place of love. Always from love, yo. And you want it to be authentic to yourself, not what you think that you want. You may think you want money and a giant house and a car, but that might not necessarily be what's gonna make you happy. So try and figure out, what does my heart want? What does my soul want? What's gonna lift me up for the rest of my life and make me feel really freaking good and like I did something with my life? Find that, and then the money will come. When you find something you love, money's always gonna come. Don't worry about that. Do what you love. So visualization is going to help you if you're going through a particularly tough time right now. You visualize what you want, and you visualize a future. You have something to look forward to. You have something to grind towards. You know what I mean? Like, when you start figuring out, oh, I want this, the universe will conspire to make it so and to give you what it is that you want. So figure out what you want. Ask for help. Visualize. Put that out there. Affirm what it is that you want. Okay. I know this is really hard. This is still a really hard, tough time for a lot of people. But when you stay in a mindset of being grateful for what it is that you already have, and then you visualize what it is that you want, you stay positive and you hold on to that. Just hold on to that. This tough time is going to be over super soon. The life of your dreams is around the corner. So those are my six tips. Six everyday tips that you can do to help through this high energetic time of a lot of change, a lot of transformation, a lot of unfolding into the world that is to come. These things can help you through this. And I hope that you take something positive away from this video. If you're on the Instagram or the Snapchat, you should follow me. We got Instagram. We got a Snap. Follow you, girl. Like, por favor, share it with someone if you like it. I just want more people to be aware of what's happening and be able to do their own research, go on their own little journey. So the more people to see it, the more possible people will be able to embrace what is happening in this world a lot easier, because it ain't easy. But if you know what's going on, it's a lot easier to handle it. Thank you for watching. Oh, I gotta say it. If you like it, subscribe. Subscribe. Push the button. Push the button. Push that button. Subscribe to your girl's channel. I'm strange. I have come to that conclusion. I've learned to embrace it. Because it's who I am. I've always been this way. I'm not like it. I don't care. I love you. Thank you for watching. That's lit. You the real MVP, bruh. And I got love for you. Have a great, wonderful, amazing, blessed, immaculate Sunday. I love you.